Charles IV, King of Bohemia and Holy Roman Emperor, had a long, unsuccessful reign. The empire he ruled from Prague expanded, and his subjects lived in peace and prosperity. When the emperor died, the whole empire mourned. More than 7,000 people accompanied him on his last procession. The heir to the throne of the flourishing empire was Charles's son, Wenceslas IV, whose father had prepared him for this moment all his life. But Wenceslas did not take after his father. He neglected affairs of state for more frivolous pursuits. He even failed to turn up for his own coronation as emperor, which did little to endear him to the Pope. Wenceslas the Idle did not impress the imperial nobility either. His difficulties mounted until the nobles, exasperated by the inaction of their ruler, turned for help to his half-brother, King Sigismund of Hungary. Sigismund decided on a radical solution. He kidnapped the king to force him to abdicate, then took advantage of the ensuing disorder to gain greater power for himself. He invaded Bohemia with a massive army and began pillaging the territories of the king's allies. It is here that my story begins.
God bless.
Same to you.
Today's a scorcher.
Well, ho,
husband. How goes it?
Good. I should get it finished today. Where on earth is Henry? I need him to run some errands.
He was still sleeping when I went out.
At this hour? Blue-blooded idler.
Well, it looks like he was out all evening, drinking like a lord.
Go and get the lazy bones up then. Quick clout round the ear should do it.
Henry! Get up now. There's work to be done.
Mother! Get up or I'll come get you up, you slug of bed.
Hear that? You'd better not vex him. Now get up quick. Your breakfast is on the table. Wait, what's this? Have you been... Oh, Henry. How many times have I told you about fighting?
Oh, it's nothing. It's just a scratch.
You've been at that sword play again, haven't you? You'd better pray your father doesn't get to hear of it. You know how he feels about it.
Oh, don't worry, it wasn't that. I just scratched myself, is all.
Well, just don't come crying to me if you really do get hurt. Now get up, you rogue. Fine state you're in this morning. What on earth did you get up to last night?
Nothing much. Me and the lads were just having a chat in the tavern. Some wayfarer stopped by. He was telling us what's going on in the world and, I lost track of time.
Well, I hope he didn't fill your head with nonsense. Well, I've got a feeling there's something you're not telling me. And it's connected with that scratch on your hand. And that suspicious-looking character with a sword who turned up in town recently.
I was with Bianca. Do you want a blow-by-blow account of everything we did? What's this, an interrogation?
All right. Sorry, son. It's just that I worry about you.
Thanks, Ma, but I'm not 4 years old.
I know, Hal. You've grown up in front of my eyes. It's hard to get used to it.
Is Father angry with me for sleeping late?
He's not happy. Yesterday you promised him you'd help finish that sword for Sir Radzik. He's not as young as he was. And you know how his joints pain him. He's too proud to complain, but he needs your help, Henry.
I know. Don't worry, Ma. Of course I'll help him.
Good. He always says his knees ache when there's a storm coming. I hope they're wrong this time. It's looking like such a nice day.
Did Matthew and Fritz come looking for me?
No, I haven't seen them this morning. They shouldn't be hard to find. They'll be hanging around a tavern somewhere, as usual.
Mother.
You're nearly a grown man, Hal. Father will pass the forge on to you one day soon. You've been courting that Bianca for months now. Why do you have to keep wasting your time with those two layabouts? They're nothing but trouble.
Do you need me to do anything, Ma?
Ah, you're a good lad. But I'm fine. It's your father needs helping with that sword.
At least you're up, that's a start. Anyway, we've a lot of work to do today. I'm finishing the sword for Sir Radzik, and I need your help.
With what?
I'm running out of charcoal. Run to the market and buy a bag from the charcoal burner.
I'll need some money then.
Yeah, that's the other thing. Kunesh still owes me for an axe, a hammer, and the nails I sold him a month ago. Not to mention his debt from before. Go and tell him to pay up, at least for the axe and hammer, and then use the money to buy the charcoal.
Kunesh, that drunkard. That'll be fun.
Well, you're a big lad now. I'm sure you can manage. If not, tell him that next time I'll come myself and personally use that hammer to bang those nails into his arse.
Sure he'll be happy to hear it. Is that all?
Not quite. The Chamberlain at the castle has the cross guard for Sir Radzik's sword, which I had engraved in Sassau.
You want me to go and pick it up? All right. Money, charcoal, cross guard. Got it.
And ale. Stop off at the tavern on your way home. I know you'll be going there anyway to see that girl of yours. But make sure the ale's still cool from the cellar when you get back.
Her name is Bianca.
Right, so make sure Bianca draws me a nice cool one. Run along now, work won't wait.
How goes trade?
Well, well. And now I see you, I hope it will go in. Can you not see I'm busy with Master Favour here? If it's charcoal you want, lad.
I've got everything you need.
How are you?
Welcome, Master Tobias.
God be with you, Helen. How goes trade?
See you later.
Hmm.
strong to sue up anything.
You can't be serious, Deutsch. Insulting our king.
What insult? I say only the truth. Sigismund has done only what he had to.
Had to. He had to abduct the king. He had to lure his cousin Prokop into a trap and imprison him. He had to invade with his army of Tatars and besiege Gutenberg.
Why not? What is this Wenceslas for a king? The empire is falling asunder in his hands. The German counts elected Ruprecht of the Palatinate as king because your Wenceslas would not go to their deeds even.
German counts, traitors.
Now even the Pope.
God be with you, Henry.
I'm with you, Matthew. What's going on here?
Deutsch is spouting shit.
What?
Just listen and you'll hear for yourself.
Someone has to bring order and reunite the empire.
What do I care about the Austrians? And nowadays, not even the devil himself can keep up with all the popes. Which is the rightful pope? The one in Rome or the one in Avignon?
Do not blaspheme, Alex.
No, it's true, though. Wenceslas is the king of Bohemia. Bohemian nobles are on his side. To hell with Rosenberg and his cabal. Sir Ratzik is Wenceslas' commander-in-chief. He stayed loyal to the king. And if he heard you talking like this, he would have you whipped like a dog.
Your deed will soon have nothing left to rule. Jobs had to sell Luxembourg to help your king. South Bohemia is with Sigismund and...
Don't forget about Gutenberg, where Germans like you kissed Sigismund's feet to keep their heads.
Yes, but...
Goodman Deutsch, this is pointless. Let us talk of more pleasant things.
My words exactly.
Deutsch has gone too far. Wenceslas is our rightful king.
Deutsch is an idiot. But what can you do?
I might have an idea. Deutsch deserves to be taught a lesson. Doesn't he, Fritz?
You're too right, Matthew. You should give him a proper hiding.
Are you mad? Do you want to end up in the pillory?
Don't listen to Fritz. I've got a better idea. Deutsch was talking such shit, it made me think of that huge pile of manure. You know, the one right next to his freshly whitewashed house.
You think we should redecorate for him? Count me in.
Well, I'd rather torch it, to be honest. But doing some tears will do.
What do you say, Henry?
But I was going to get ale for father and a few other things. We're finishing Sir Ratzik's sword.
Come on. Doing a few handfuls of manure is not going to take all day.
And it's our duty to defend the honor of our king.
So, how? Are you with us?
Not that I don't want to teach the Deutsch a lesson, but I really don't have time.
Well, that's disappointing. Still, we can manage without you. Let's go, lads.
Honestly, hell. How could you pass a good chance like this?
God save, my lovely. You're looking well today.
You too, handsome. What brings you here?
Your beauty, of course.
Oh, noble sir. I'm as honored as any simple maid can be. And apart from my beauty?
Henry, I'm glad you...
What else might your worship desire?
I need ale, but father told me to go and see Cunesh first.
I see. So shouldn't you be doing that then?
But I needed to gather strength by looking at your beautiful face.
Henry, you buffoon! I'll bring it right away.
Rags, fabric, brocade, sacraments and tools! You'll find it all! Everything for work and home!
Thank you. Lord watch over you.
Hey, Pip! Do you want to learn? Have you recovered from yesterday's great wound?
Oh, it was nothing. Except Mother noticed and had a word or two to say about it.
No mother's happy when a son starts to take an interest in swords. Where there's weapons, there's death. The question is, what do you want?
I don't want to rot in this hole forever. I feel like I don't belong here. I want to live and see the world. The world's a dangerous place and I need to know how to protect myself.
Spoken like a man. And as it happens, today's your last chance. I have to leave. So, are you ready to get stuck in?
Yes.
All right, I wait on the ground by the sheepfold as usual. So, can we get started?
We can.
Good. And since today's the last time we'll be seeing each other, you can show me everything I've taught you so far. Very well. Let's start with the basics. Keep moving. Your life depends on it. All right. Now try to hit me. You have to put your weight into your attack. If you just fiddle around, you'll get nowhere. Try slashing from different sides. Unpredictability is the key. Never repeat yourself. Very good. All right. Good. Very good. Good. Once again, the point of the blade is for stabbing. Try it a few times. Fine. Nice. All right. Good, good. Let's try something else. One strike, I can fend off without a sweat. But if you chain your strikes, I'll have a much harder time. As soon as you land one blow, follow it with another. You, but I'm I'm tired and thirsty. Remember, though, train hard. No one becomes a master swordsman overnight. You have to work and work. And the main thing is to use what you've learned in real combat. There's nothing better than experience, believe me.
God be with you, Kunesh.
What do you want?
My father sent me to get the coin you owe him for the axe, hammer, and nails.
I've got nothing. Clear off.
Father says if you don't pay up, he'll come here himself and hammer those nails into your hairy ass.
I'd like to see him try. Fuck off, you bastard, or your old man will be pulling those nails out of you.
Look, I know things aren't easy. Wife ran off, booze is dear these days, and you're as much use as a square wheel. It's no wonder you're short of coin. But a debt's a debt, and I can't leave here without something.
You son of a whore. How dare you speak to me like that? Didn't your thieving father teach you any manners? No? Well, I'll teach you then. Take care.
Kurva! You're dead!
Give up. Take what you want. It's not much, but it's all I have. You understand?
Thank you.
right, blacksmith's boy. You got the better of me. Take what you want, but you haven't heard the last of this. Right, try that one more.
I'd like to discuss the price.
Why not?
Here. And something for your trouble.
My word, thank you kindly.
Greetings, Henry. Greetings, Henry.
I need ale for father.
A pitcher as usual?
Aye. Bring me a cool one from the cellar.
But of course.
God be with you.
Thanks.
It's on me today. You can pay me back this evening.
Out of the question. Here you go. And this evening I'll have something more for you.
I can't wait.
Thanks. You'll have something to look forward to this evening.
You too. Oh, by the way, that shifty-looking fellow was asking after you.
Vaniak?
I suppose. He's a man who makes his coin robbing honest wayfarers. I'm sure of it. I'll be happy when he's gone for good. But what in heaven's name are you up to with him?
He promised to teach me how to use a sword.
What use would that be to you?
Enough. You sound just like Father. I'll be going now. See you this evening.
Hal, I've got something special for you.
Is that so? Now what would that be?
Your favorite, Savior Schnapps.
Really? You're an angel.
I hope you'll thank me properly later.
You bet I will.
With you.
I'm with you, Henry.
How are you?
I've just been to the tavern. Deutsch was saying all kinds of shit about how Sigismund should be king.
That bastard. One day he'll get his teeth knocked down his throat if he doesn't shut up.
Father sent me. We're forging a sword for Sir Radzik. And the Chamberlain has the crossguard and pommel. Father had them engraved in Sassau.
Right. They're here. The Chamberlain gave them to us for you. We looked them over. Beautiful work. I've never seen anything so fine.
I can't wait to see the sword. Just make sure you don't botch it.
And did I ever botch anything?
Where shall I start?
Shut up and give me what I want, or I'll kick your ass this evening.
Right away, your lordship.
Magnificent. Shame I can't keep the sword for myself. Well, I better go if we're to get the job done by this evening.
Godspeed. See you later in the tavern.
You certainly will. After today's work, the ale might even be on me.
There you are, Henry. Father's been asking.
It's all taken care of, Mother.
About time. Have you got everything I wanted?
I have charcoal, the hilt, and the ale. We can start.
Good job. Let's have it then, son. Well... Right. Let's see what kind of job the master in Sassau did for us. Look at that, lad. That's what I call craftsmanship.
What does the inscription mean?
Damned if I know. Doesn't look like Czech to me. Latin, maybe? Lord Radzig ordered it. Oh, this will be the finest sword I've ever made. Have you got the charcoal? Good. Then fire up the forge. We'll put it all together. By the way, I heard some gossip about what happened to Deutsch. I expect you know something about it.
Maybe.
Maybe? Someone threw dung at Deutsch's freshly lime-washed house, maybe. And maybe those cronies of yours had something to do with it.
That Deutsch was talking treason in the tavern about Sigismund and the king. He got what he deserved.
Oh, got what he deserved, did he? Look, I don't know if you're mixed up in this or if it's just those friends of yours. It's all the same to me. But I have a trade to run. The German pays well. And having my son in the pillory helps nothing and nobody, least of all the king. Do you understand?
Yes.
Look me in the eye, Henry. Do you understand?
I understand.
Good. Then we'll never have this conversation again.
So you think it's right to let traitors speak ill of the king?
Does that boy ever listen to a word I say? So Deutsch spouts rubbish, so what? You might win a fight with violence, but you'll never win an argument. Remember, Henry, if you want to convince someone that they're wrong, try using your mouth and not your fists.
Furnace is ready.
Right, we'll do the grip. I'll heat it up. When I take it out, you slip the grip on so it fits exactly. You know what you're doing. Do it. Good. Once more. That's it. Done. Now file it down so it sits well in the hand. I'll prepare the guard.
Father, why did you leave Prague? Who ever heard of a master swordsmith making horseshoes in a village?
I had my reasons, Hal. And here I have your mother and you. Why would I want any other life?
Do you remember Emperor Charles?
I do. Life was good under his reign.
Better than now.
He built half of Prague and a score of castles. Had a bridge made over the Moldau and founded a university, and all without a war. He knew how to rule.
Better than Wenceslas.
Better by far. But Wenceslas doesn't have it easy. It's hard to step into the shoes of someone whose like is born only once 1,000 years.
What about Sigismund?
You think Charles would have brought an army down on his own people like Sigismund? No. Wenceslas may not be the equal of his father, but Sigismund, he brings shame to the royal name. How's it going? Give it here, and we'll put it all together.
It's magnificent.
Indeed it is. The Lord be with you. My father sent me for those nails.
Good day to you, Teresa. They're ready. Will you fetch them for me, Hal? They're in the trunk in the living room.
Here are those nails you wanted.
Thanks. So, how's Bianca?
She's fine. Why do you ask?
Just wondering. Will you be going to the dance this evening?
We will.
Maybe we'll see each other there. Anyway, mustn't keep you. I'll be on my way. That sword is truly beautiful.
Fine lass, eh? Now, stop staring at her and come and see this. It's time for the trial by fire. We did a fine job.
I would expect nothing less from such a renowned swordsmith.
Well, those days are gone, sir.
You haven't lost your skills, though. Would you like to try it?
Sir, what good is a sword to a commoner?
Let him try it. You still have a lot to learn. Ask your father to show you how. He knows what he's about.
Learning his trade will serve him better in life, sir.
Perhaps. But who knows what the future holds for each of us. I see that you almost have it finished.
It just needs a polish, then Henry will bring it to you.
Excellent. Fine work, very fine. A sword such as this will bring honor to its bearer. What say you, sir, Isvan?
True, Sir Radzik. If I'd have had its like back in Nicopolis, things would have worked out differently. How odd to find such an accomplished swordsmith working in a place like this. A man of his talent would have no problem making a fortune in Prague or Vienna.
You're right. It's a very long and peculiar story.
I'd be glad to listen to it over a cup of wine, but duty calls and I must leave. Here you are. Learn from your father. He truly is a master of his craft.
I'm sure our paths will cross again.
They certainly will.
Once it's ready, send your son up to me with it. Good work, Martin.
Sure.
It's been an honor, Sir Isvan. Have a safe journey to Sassau.
The honor is mine, Sir Radzik. Thank you for the hospitality.
A long, peculiar history.
That was a long time ago. I might tell you about it sometime, but not today.
Will you teach me how to use it, like Sir Radzik said?
Why?
Well, it could come in useful. Maybe I'll travel a bit before settling down. I'd like to know more than the tavern on the green and the forge.
You know the trouble with an adventurous life, son? It can end before it gets started. I might teach you how to handle a sword, and then someone will shoot you with a crossbow as soon as you set foot outside the house.
You talk as if you've seen it happen.
A man my age has seen a lot. Being a blacksmith might bring no glory, but it has its benefits, like keeping your head on your shoulders. I want to end my days in Scalitz, here. Beneath the linden tree and by your mother's side.
Well, so do I, one day. But first, I'd like to see the world, meet new people.
Meet them or beat them?
Meet. You have to keep going on about it.
Then you've no need to learn swordplay.
A messenger.
He was in a hurry. What's happened?
Thank you.
Listen carefully. Take the sword, go into the house, and grab anything else important from the trunk. Go to the castle. Hurry.
What about you?
Your mother is in the village. I'll fetch her and we'll follow right behind.
I'll go with you.
No. You do what I say right now. Give the sword to Sir Radzik. If anything happens, he'll take care of you. He owes me.
Closing!
Move it, people!
Come on!
Come on!
Time.
Oh, Henry! Thank God! Get inside quick! We have to shut the
gates! Get running, people! Come on!
Mind this for me!
Are you mad? You can't go back!
Get through the gates!
Ah!
You pigs! Don't touch me, or I'll kill you!
God almighty, no, please. Yeah. Left. Talmburg is to the left, along the stream. Run for it! Run for it! Warn the others! They've torched Scalic! Yeah.
Megöllek, de tüdös!
Eltaposlak, mint egy tetvet!
Someone give him a drink and bring hot wine and bandages. Tell me, boy, who are you and where are you from? What in hell's name happened?
I've come from Scalitz. They burned it to the ground.
slaughtered everyone.
Who? Who burned it to the ground?
A huge army. They attacked without warning. And they weren't Czechs or Germans either.
Who then?
I don't know. I've never seen armor like it or heard their language. Maybe Tatars?
Tatars, you say?
Yeah.
Well, we'll deal with that later. First, let's have a look at that leg of yours.
I don't know.
Grit your teeth, boy. I'm gonna pull that arrow out. Easy. All done. You were lucky, lad. The arrow missed the bone. It only needed bandaging, and I've done that often enough before. War is a good teacher. Can you stand? There you go. Good as new.
Thank you.
Have you idlers nothing better to do? Get back to work. You'll have to speak to Lord Divish. Can you manage? Sir, this is a survivor from...
I heard, Robart. Tell me, boy, what exactly happened? Did you see the ensigns of the attackers? And were there any more survivors?
Sir, I don't know what army it was, but it was huge. There were dozens of banners flying on the hill above Skalitz. The ones who did the slaughtering spoke a strange language. They burned Skalitz to the ground. But a lot of people took refuge in the castle. I wasn't quick enough. And as I fled, they shouted from the battlements that I should come and warn you.
The soldiers the boy didn't recognize. They could be those Cumans of Sigismund's. It said they came to Hungary from the east, and now they're the core of his army. Sacking Gutenberg must have given him a taste for stolen silver.
Skalitz is a small castle, sir. If Sigismund attacks, they can't hold.
Indeed, Sir Robart. And our small garrison would be no help, even if we could risk sending them.
You think we're next in line?
Maybe. What's your name, boy?
I'm Henry, son of the Skalitz blacksmith.
I know him. Did he make it inside the castle? I'm sorry. It's in God's hands now. No one else can help us. Anyway, thank you for risking your neck to warn us. Robard, take care of Henry. Make sure he gets something to eat and some rest.
Yes, sir.
And get all the people inside the gates. We have to prepare for the worst. Make all the necessary arrangements.
As you command, sir.
What's happening with that blacksmith?
He can't come tomorrow. As soon as he can, it's before noon, the day after.
You've done well, lad. I'm sorry for your loss. You must be all done in. Why don't you go to the kitchen and have a good meal? Sorrow is easier to bear on a full stomach.
I have to eat something.
I heard
my insides are shriveled up
with
hunger.
They say he was a swordsmith who moved to the countryside to make horseshoes. I can't understand why he'd waste his talents, but I'm...
Huh?
Ah, milady. You are fortunate our good lady Stephanie of Talmberg has graced us with her presence.
My lady, I'm honored.
So this is our brave young man? Welcome, lad. Bojena here will take care of you. No doubt you're tired and hungry.
Indeed. How could he not be, poor soul? After everything he's been through, he must be as hungry as a bear, aren't you, young master? Here you are, then. Eat your fill.
And a little wine to wash it down.
Thank you, my lady.
When you're done, you can go and rest with the grooms in the outer bailey.
No, that won't do, Sir Robard. After all he's been through, he deserves a proper bed. Let him sleep in a lodge in the courtyard.
Certainly, my lady. Young Henry here is overwhelmed by your generosity.
Yes, yes. Thank you, my lady. May God reward you for your kindness.
Eat up now. You're in capable hands, so I'll leave you to it. Good night.
Good night.
Good night, ma'am.
When you've done, you can sleep in the bedchamber of the courtyard lodge. And don't forget to take off those filthy boots before getting into bed.
Eat food.
You're that lad from Scarlet's. What never? How ill-mannered.
I feel quite hungry. Jesus. I could really do with some sleep.
Yes?
It is I, Henry. Forgive the intrusion. I didn't wake you, boy, did I?
My lady, No, not at all. But what brings you here at this hour?
I thought you could do with a little wine. It's just what you need to help you sleep.
My lady, thank you. You really shouldn't. You could have sent a sermon.
I was going to. But to tell you the truth, I couldn't sleep either. I thought of you while saying my prayers. How awful it must have been for you. I came to offer you solace, to let you know you're not alone.
Thank you. Thank you kindly.
You're welcome. Now, Henry, I know this is all very new and strange for you, but I want you to feel at home here. You're not to worry about anything except getting better. God knows you've been through a terrible ordeal. I know what it is to be left alone in the world, although your loss is much greater. But with God's help, the pain will ease in time. And it can help to talk about it, if you feel like it.
You might be right, my lady. I'll tell you what happened. It was terrible and unexpected. The day started just like any other. Father sent me into town on some errands. I went to the tavern to buy ale for Father. I know it's a job for a groom, but I didn't mind, because my girl Bianca worked there. I courted her a while and we agreed to meet in the evening. But our meeting was never to happen.
Oh, dear boy.
When I'd done all the errands, I headed back home. I promised Father I'd help him with his work, and I was looking forward to it. He was forging a sword for Sir Radzig. The sword was taking shape when Sir Radzig himself came to have a look at it. He praised Father's work and said that with his smithing skills, he could easily make a living in Prague or Vienna.
You don't say.
But Sigismund's horde was already on the horizon, ready to attack the town. A horde of soldiers was amassed. Pennants flapped in the wind, the armor glinted in the sunlight, and the horses whinnied impatiently. They were waiting for Sigismund to give the command to attack.
How awful.
And then death descended on Skalitz. Father told me to take shelter in the castle while he went to get Mother. She was stranded in the town, surrounded by Sigismund's butchers. And then I saw him knocking down one Cuman after another. I never saw him fight like that. But then the leader of Sigismund's raiding party, a knight in full armor, saw Father and charged at him. He cut down my father without a thought. And then he turned on my mother. And he murdered her in cold blood.
You poor boy. May the Lord have mercy on their souls.
I ran to the castle like our neighbors to take cover, but I didn't make it. I had to find another way to save myself. The men on the battlements called down to me to flee to Talmberg and warn you. I was lucky I knew a concealed path around the castle. I needed a horse to get to the safety of Talmberg and to warn you all.
And with all that was happening, you thought of others like a good Christian.
Then I heard a scream. It was Teresa, the mill wench. She'd been caught by a gang of Cuman savages who planned to violate her. I had Sir Radzik's sword, and even though there were several of them and they were better armed, I had to try and save her. I wanted there to be at least one person I'd helped. And I succeeded, even though it almost cost me my life. After that, I stole a horse from them and rode off.
Like a valiant knight.
I'll never forget the horror. It will haunt me for the rest of my life.
That's terrible. How could something like that happen?
God alone knows why he lets such things happen.
Oh, you poor boy. I understand your grief, but God is not to blame for the ills of this world. That is the work of Satan and those who do his bidding. Those who are corrupted by greed, envy, and pride. You must not lose faith, whatever life brings. Fate has not been merciful to me, and my husband either. Although in comparison to the horrors he went through. I was young when I married my husband. It was my father's wish. Divish was a lot older than I, but a woman must bear her lot. Shortly after our marriage, before I even got a look at Talmberg, the castle was stormed and my husband was imprisoned.
Really?
My husband had some quarrel with Sir Havel Medek of Valdek, who decided to resolve it by force. He stormed the castle, burned down the village of Pribislavitz, and killed many of our men, even the old Chamberlain. He imprisoned my husband in the castle and put his own garrison there.
That's awful.
I was barely 18 years old, and all of a sudden, I was left alone with Sir Robert. We didn't know what to do. We went to Prague to appeal to the king and sought help from Divish's friends, but all to no avail. We tried for years, but it seemed I was destined to be left alone and my husband to rot in jail in his own castle.
Years, you say?
7 years. That's how long it took before Havel was condemned as an enemy of the crown. And even then, he refused to surrender the castle and release my husband. In the end, I raised the money to pay a ransom, and only then, by the grace of Lord Jesus, did I finally lay eyes on my husband once more.
7 years. And was Havel punished for it?
Never. And after 7 years, my husband returned to me an infirm old man.
Sir Divish seems like a good, strong man.
Well, certainly, only he has many concerns. He had to rebuild Talmberg. After he was released, the king appointed him Burgrave of Prague Castle, and he was very busy. He had no time for me at all. But at least we were in the city, and there was something going on. And now, we're here.
My lady, you're still young and beautiful. Your best years are still ahead of you.
Would that that were true, lad. Would it were true. But what am I doing bothering you with this? You have troubles enough of your own. I'll go and let you sleep. I enjoyed our little talk, Henry. Good night, and God bless.
Good night, my lady.
Henry, wake up. You don't want to miss this.
What is there? What's happening?
Come to the battlements. One of our patrols reported a company heading here from Skellets.
Not that I'm spoiling for a fight.
Listen up. If it's Sigismund and his army, prepare for the worst. But don't be daunted by their numbers. Heed my commands, and all will end well.
What's going on?
I don't know. It doesn't make sense. Why would Sigismund advance on Talmud in the night? Especially since he's lost the element of surprise after the raid on Skellets.
Maybe it's not him.
Then who is it? The scouts Givis sent to Skellets to spy on Sigismund said he'd set up camp and was getting ready to storm the castle. And Sir Radzig is an experienced soldier. He'd surely hold the castle for quite some time. It doesn't make sense.
What else did the spy see?
Not much of anything. Before they could get close enough, this huge storm started. And you were right. Sigismund has a hell of a lot of soldiers, including all manner of mercenaries. An army like that is important. Well, anyway, we'll find out when they get here, won't we?
Aye, we will.
Take care.
And all his minions. Who else, Robert?
Sir Radzig. What a relief.
Is his lordship there with you?
Yes, sir. He is right here.
What are you doing up so late, Divish? At your age, you need a good night's sleep.
Well, Radzig, you didn't exactly pick the best time for an outing either. In a big hurry?
It was a bit of a scramble, all right. Believe it or not, this tempest is a godsend for me and my men. As my old granddad used to say, better a sore throat than a slit throat.
I'd say your grandfather was a wise man. Your messenger told us what happened.
Messenger?
The lad you sent to warn us.
He's alive? He made it to you?
He's here with me. He only got away by the skin of his teeth, though.
Thank God.
A brave young man. But tell me, friend, how on earth did you manage to get away?
Thank God for this tempest. When it began, Sigismund's Tatars crawled into their holes and left a storm in the castle for more clement weather. We were able to sneak out right under their noses. The Lord be praised. We wouldn't have stood a chance against them.
Would you like to spend the night in Tumber?
No, no. When Sigismund finds the castle empty tomorrow, he might come looking for us. We'd only be exposing you to danger. Without me and my men, he has no call to attack you.
Well, what will you do then?
We'll march to Rattai. It's only a short way, and there we'll have a better chance of defense and enough room for all of these people. If Sigismund should come, better bend your knee, Divish. There's no point dying in a battle that's futile.
You're right there.
Is that boy still with you?
I'm here, sir.
You have courage, lad. That I can't deny. I am sorry about what happened. Would you care to join us?
I'd like to, sir, but first I have to return to Scalitz.
Are you mad? What do you want there?
I can't leave my mother and father. I won't leave their corpses rotting in the street. I'll join you once I've taken care of them.
Don't even think of going back there, you donkey. Are you tired of living?
But sir...
Quiet! I'm sorry about your father, but getting killed as well won't help him. Divish, make sure that lad doesn't budge from Talmberg until things quieten down.
Not to worry, friend. Anyway, he's injured and needs to recover. I'll lock him up here as if he were Havel of Baldic.
I see you've grown a thick skin since your tribulation, sir. But thank you. We'll meet again when circumstances are more favorable. Farewell.
Farewell, friend. And good fortune. Give my regards to Sir Hanush.
I will. And good luck to you and your people, too. These are dark times.
Tonight we'll have triple patrol. Sort out the watches between you as always.
What is it you need?
I could use an extra pair of eyes, and yours are keen. Will you keep watch on the battlements with my men?
Is that a request or an order?
I'd rather it was a request you answered yesterday.
Of course I'll help. I have to pay you back somehow after all you've done for me.
Splendid. And don't worry. I'll tell the men to relieve you later.
Good day to you. What do you need?
What do you think about that surprise during the night?
I was surprised, all right. I'm glad them people were saved, though. I'm just as glad it weren't Sigismund. For sure he'll come here in the end, too. But now at least we've got time to get ready for him.
Maybe he'll leave Talmberg be.
Maybe, maybe not. Could be he was only out to get Sir Radzik, because he's Wenceslas's headman. The Scarlets is a rich town, so there was plenty of loot for the taking. Two birds with one stone. So he might be satisfied and leave us alone.
Reckon we'll see soon enough, one way or the other.
Wandering around like a stray sheep. Must be your first watch, eh? I don't think anything much will be happening today. You can just lean against the wall and wait till morning. I'll show you what to do.
I will. Thank you.
Thank you.
Let's go! Let's go! Move it! Quick! Go! Go!
Self-appointed king wins the love and respect of his loyal subjects.
Indeed, Robard. Sigismund of Luxembourg has a rare talent for winning people over to his cause. We may be in for a surprise. I don't think he will set his heathen dogs on us today.
Greetings, Lord of Tomberg.
That's the bastard who led the attack at Scarlet and killed my parents.
Don't be an idiot. Do you want to end up like them?
I am Sir Markvart von Aulitz. I come in the name of Sigismund of Luxembourg, King of Hungary and Croatia, who has resolved to strike against those who disrupt concord in the land and to restore order in the name of his brother, King Wenceslaus IV.
Restore order by burning and pillaging the king's estates.
Greetings, Sir Markvart. The efforts of the king's brother to bring order to this chaotic land are undoubtedly noble. It seems to me, though, that he and his army have somewhat strayed. As Burgrave of Prague Castle, I am entirely beholden to the king. And here in Taumburg, divine peace reigned until your arrival. To what, then, do we owe the honor of your visit?
Yesterday, His Majesty took action against the enemy of the kingdom, Sir Radzig Kobila, who has been using the silver from the Scarlet's mine to fund insurrection against the crown. Unfortunately, the insurgent escaped. Would you happen to know, noble sir, where he might be at this time?
As far as I know, the Sir Radzik of which you speak is the king's hetman at Skalitz. I find it hard to imagine that he would rebel against our king. Nevertheless, I can assure you that Sir Radzik is not at Taumburg. He would be a fool indeed to flee from one castle, where he has little chance of defense, to another, where he has even less. Or do you take the view that my humble manner is any obstacle to your army?
Am I to inform the king, then, that Sir Radzik Kobila is not at Taumburg and that he has your loyalty?
Sir Radzik Kobila is not here, and I have no intentions of getting embroiled in affairs from which I have nothing to gain.
Very well, sir. As you wish. I will relay your words to the king in the hope he will be as well disposed as you seem to be.
Those who have clean consciences and goodwill may find themselves well disposed even at moments like this, when there is little cause for joy. Farewell, sir.
Auf Wiedersehen.
My lord, you have my utmost admiration.
Get on with you, Robard.
Look out.
Good health, you.
Why did Sigismund burn down Scalitz and then come here, too?
That's war for you, lad. Certain lords have resolved to take things into their own hands and eliminate anyone who doesn't share their view. Unfortunately, Sir Radzig is one of those. And what's more, he was sitting on a pile of silver that could help King Wenceslas's allies.
What happened in Gutenberg?
Gutenberg? Well, I'm just a simple soldier, but the good lord gave me ears, and I've heard some things from Sir Divish and from those who fled from Sigismund's pillaging.
Were there many?
Indeed. But it was the Gutenberg mercenaries who came to see me, because I knew them from before.
I see.
Listen, lad, these are all games of the high aristocracy. In Prague, a cabal of nobles rebelled against King Wenceslas, wealthy aristocrats who took against our king for reasons of their own. There's no doubt Sigismund had his fingers in the whole affair, him and Wenceslas's cousin, Jobst. And that cabal helped him abduct the king.
So then why did Sigismund attack Gutenberg?
Why do you think?
I suppose because it has a strategic position and good fortifications, so it can be used as a base for raids, giving you control of the whole territory and good defenses too, if you need them.
Not at all. King Charles, may God grant him eternal glory, built Prague into a proper royal city, while King Wenceslas took a liking to Gutenberg. After Prague, it's the most important city in Bohemia, in the entire Holy Roman Empire. He who commands the Gutenberg silver is king.
So Gutenberg sided with Wenceslas because he favored it?
Now you're starting to understand. When Sigismund imprisoned Wenceslas and took control of Prague, the people of Gutenberg began to raise an army against him. So with the attack on Gutenberg, Sigismund killed two birds with one stone. He defeated Wenceslas's most powerful allies before they could stand against him, and also gained immense wealth.
Where did these Cumans come from, anyway?
I don't know much about them, only what the Chamberlain said. That they came to Hungary from the east and settled there. They're godless barbarians and merciless fighters. The nobles used to say the Hungarian king shouldn't enlist them, because they dishonor our rules of warfare. But when there's power and money to be had, it seems that honor isn't worth my spit. And believe me, it's always about power and money.
Sir Robart, I need to get to Scalitz.
What would you do there, lad? Sigismund might have left, but the place will be swamped with robber barons, brigands, deserters, and other vermin. And anyway, your lord commanded you to stay here.
Sir Robart, my parents died there. I can't leave them to be eaten by dogs. What would you do in my place?
Sorry, lad, but I won't take orders. You'll have to wait until everything settles down, and maybe your lord will change his mind.
God be with you.
Good day to you.
What do you think about Sigismund withdrawing?
It was a stroke of good luck. I know everyone says how clever Sir Divish is and all that, but it was a dangerous situation. That Sigismund is awful, unpredictable. He abducts the king, raids towns, brings foreign mercenaries into the heart of our country. God alone knows what he'll get up to next.
May the Lord watch over you.
Jesus Christ be praised.
Is there someone here who trades in goods?
Votava is your man. He's the local dealer, a skinny fellow. I saw him by the granary. He'll buy anything that has any value, and he'd sell you his own granny. If he hadn't already sold her long since. Good luck to you.
What?
It's terrible what's going on in our land these days.
Good health to you.
Can we trade?
If you've got the coin.
The Lord watch over you.
God be with you. Good luck to you.
God be with you.
I need to get out of here.
And I need a feather bed with a comely wench in it. But it looks like we'll both be disappointed. Sir Divish gave orders not to open the gate. And you especially are not to be let out.
My mother and father were left in skallets like carrion. I have to bury them. I can't leave them to the dogs.
I'm sorry, my friend, but I can't. You'll have to persuade Sir Robard, or think something up so I don't end up in the shit for it. Otherwise, forget it.
What am I supposed to think up?
How should I know? Maybe some disguise so I could say I didn't recognize you? If a Townburg soldier turns up, all kitted out properly, in armor and a helmet, then of course I let him go. That's obvious.
All right, I'll have a look around for something.
Farewell.
God be with you. Do you need anything? Take care.
The Lord save you. What do you need?
I would like to ask your assistance, my lady, if I may be so bold.
What's the matter, lad?
I need to get out of the castle, and your husband is keeping me here by force.
Why, for the love of God, would you want to leave the castle?
My lady, I know you have a good heart. I can't live with the thought of my parents being left in the mud to be food for stray dogs. How can their souls find peace until they rest in hallowed ground?
My dear boy, you'd risk your own life to give them a Christian burial. My heart goes out to you. I will do what I can to help, though I'll tremble in fear until your return. But what can I do?
If I could just get past the guard at the gate somehow.
But you can. If you wear a proper suit of armor, and if he can't see your face, he won't recognize you and he'll let you go.
Good thinking. And where can I get the armor?
At the armory?
Where's that?
In the gate tower. But the soldiers sleep in other places around the castle too, and you might find armor nearby.
Well, they'll certainly ask where I'm going.
You could tell them Sir Robard sent you to Ujits, to ask the parish priest how the folk there are faring.
That sounds reasonable. It's rather embarrassing, but if I'm to pay a bribe, I need money, and unfortunately, I don't have any.
How would you? Don't worry your head about it. This should be enough.
Thank you, my lady. I will repay you, I swear. Thank you, my lady. I must go now. My lady, I hope you weren't unduly distressed by the arrival of Sigismund's army this morning.
Well, it was to be expected. And thanks to God's mercy and my good husband, there was no more bloodshed. But it's something else that distresses me. Maybe my mind deceives me. But I have an evil foreboding.
You, my lady? Surely not. No evil could possibly come to you.
I fear something bigger and worse will come. That Sigismund is only another omen of imminent evil. Of great evil.
Good day to you. What do you need?
Take care now.
Thank you.
Jesus Christ be praised.
Take care now.
Can we trade?
If you've got the coin.
Take care now.
Can we do something about the price?
Naturally.
Here, and something for your trouble.
Well now, thank you very much.
Can we trade?
If you've got the coin.
May the Lord watch over you.
Let's talk. Something for your trouble.
My word.
My lady.
God be with you. I'm sorry. Do I know you?
It's me, my lady. Henry.
I didn't recognize you at all. I still think you should stay here in the safety of the castle, Henry. But I see your heart is drawing you away from here. God go with you.